People who street smart. What is your most street smart tip? Trust your gut. You see people acting normally your whole life. You know what it looks like. If you see something that makes you uncomfortable, there's a reason. Even if you don't know what it is yet. Look both ways crossing a one-way street. There may always be one idiot. Act like you're in a hurry and less people will want to bother you. If you're in an argument with somebody, and they get in your face, and then look away, there's a good chance they're about to try, and knock your head off. So many people lack situational awareness. By that I mean they are not being fully aware of their surroundings, which has been made even worse with phones and headphones. If you sense anything dodgy, trust that instinct, and do something about it. I'd rather cross the street, and look paranoid than get mugged, or even just run. This group of guys were following close behind me when I was walking home from the pub alone. They could have just been walking the same way, but as soon as I hit a corner I sprinted 100 meters or so and didn't see them again. I don't care how strong you are losing 99% of the time versus 3 people. If you're homeless, don't let anyone know where you sleep or where you stash your stuff. It's okay to meet up with a buddy and spend the day with them. And it's okay to trust the staff at the shelter. But from the first day to the last day you're homeless, don't let anyone find your stash of stuff. Once your stash is found, other homeless folks will usually clean it out, or homed people will usually throw your stuff away. Similarly, don't let anyone know where you sleep, and try not to bother anybody. If you bother people, or you consistently sleep in your car somewhere, eventually someone will notice, and that's always a recipe for trouble. Keep safe. Keep secret, and keep out of sight. If you're walking around a big city and someone walks up to you, and asks you your name, or is any way friendly, they're about to try to con you. I'm New York City, where the CD scam is prevalent. Con artist asks you your name, they your name on their hip-hop CD, and when you accept the CD they intimidate you to pay for the CD. Just keep walking, don't even smile at them. Never underestimate anybody, and I mean both ways, good and bad. I've been too, and been lost in a lot of different countries, including several where they do not advise women to go out alone, for non-religious reasons. I'm not messing with those countries. My experience is that, if you keep your head up, and your face neutral, meet people's eyes, if they're looking at you, and nod politely to acknowledge you see, and respect their space, they'll leave you alone. That said, if you start seeing hostile faces instead of disinterested ones, proceed calmly in a different direction. Act like you live wherever you are, like you know the place, like you know exactly where you are going. I use a wheelchair and do this whenever I travel. I figure out where I'm going before I venture out. If I'm lost, I duck into a store or restaurant in order to look at my phone or ask directions. Be focused on the direction you are going. And don't act like a refined tourist. Ironically, I feel much safer by myself when I can act like this instead of when I'm traveling with some clueless friend or relative who has to stop for pictures every 20 feet. I rarely, if ever, get approached for money or anything when I'm by myself, but throw in my dumb Aunt Susan and we are brushing off weirdos all day long. When visiting a new city, pick a landmark that you can see from anywhere. Maybe it's a big tower in the downtown core. Maybe it's a mountain in the distance, or the city is on the shore of a lake, or there's a river or highway that cuts through in a clear and logical way. Great. That's your orientation now. Wherever you go, you're not lost. You have that landmark. Maybe it's further away, maybe it's closer, but if you know what direction the landmark is, you can't really get turned around. Now take it a step further. As you walk around, pick a landmark in the neighborhood you are moving through. Maybe it's a corner store, or a park, or a prominent intersection, or a house with a funny roof. It doesn't matter. Between the big city landmark and the smaller neighborhood landmark, you're basically triangulated to a pretty narrowly defined area you can explore with a lot of confidence, just by keeping your bearings on which direction your two landmarks are, and if you're moving closer or further away from them. Women, don't be afraid of being impolite. If you feel threatened, Don't think, oh no, I might hurt his feelings, or well, that one time I was told I overreact, so maybe this is another one of those times. No, if someone isn't opposed, they will realize that the situation was misinterpreted. If they are a murderer, they will most likely make a big deal about how they are not going to hurt you. Don't be afraid to make a scene if you're afraid. If someone asks you, can I ask you a question? Reply with, sorry, I'm in a hurry. Or bluntly, no. If someone needs something, they will ask you directly. That is, where is the nearest gas station? Can you spare a dollar? Nothing good comes from random conversation on the street. Aimless people are generally up to no good. If you see a person walking around like they don't have a destination, or they are looking around like they don't know what to do with themselves, it means they are planning on jumping someone. They are trying to seem non-threatening while at the same time scouting for victims. They are hoping some poor oblivious person lets them get too close. The best case is they are planning to pickpocket someone. The worst case is a violent mugging. If you see someone like this, don't get near them, and definitely don't take your eyes off them. Often just staring at them is enough to discourage them, because they are cowards looking for easy prey and they don't want to be identified later. Applies to everyone. Keep your mouth shut and listen. Too many people think too much of themselves. Being straightforward, cause that's me, or believing it's your right to speak. The more you speak, the more you expose yourself. Don't put yourself out there and be a target. Smart people can use your words against you. Sit back and listen. Pay attention to how everyone act and respond. Give out as little info as you can. Protect yourself. People make pickpockets' livelihood so easy. Just check out how many phones are in people's back pockets. How many handbags dangle by the side. Easily accessible. Always put valuables in an inside, preferably zipped pocket. If you're in a notorious pickpocket area like Paris or Naples, you can even carry a fake wallet with Monopoly money in an outside pocket. When you're getting into your car, check the back seat carefully, whoever you are, wherever you are. If you look like you might rob someone, you're probably not going to get robbed. If someone's trying to hassle you, give quick, short answers as you're walking. Don't pull your phone out. Don't let them see your wallet. Don't turn your body. Ignoring them has risk. If they're a crazy person who will give chase until you acknowledge them, stopping is always a mistake. Short answers as you're walking. Always be aware of your surroundings and what's going on, especially in an unfamiliar area. Every so often, just do a scan of your environment. A good example is, when I was walking in an unfamiliar neighborhood in San Francisco. I'm originally from about 30 minutes south of SF, and I wasn't paying that much attention. I quickly scanned my environment, and noticed a guy following me, and dipping in and out of the shadows trying not to be noticed. Once I noticed him, he looked startled and stopped following me. I'm not sure what he was planning on doing, but it cold vented poorly. Pepper spray is cheap and effective. Don't leave home without it. And make sure you buy a practice bottle. You don't want your first time using pepper spray to be under duress. It's cheap enough to burn an entire bottle practicing. If you ever go to an area and you see that most windows are either gated or boarded up, no, there is a reason, and that reason isn't artistic design. Don't walk around looking like you got money. Also, don't have too much money on you at any given time. If you walk around with basic jeans and a hoodie, look like you paid less than $30 for the whole outfit, you'll look like less of a target. If you don't wanna end up in a random altercation, you shouldn't use any word or type of slang you don't know the meaning of. Words will most likely cause a violent situation every time.